Hey TechSky community. Welcome back to our channel. Today we're diving into another exciting video on Metasploit, focusing specifically on how to install it on Ubuntu. If you're new here, make sure to hit that subscribe button and click the bell icon so you never miss an update from TechSky. Before we begin, I want to mention that if you're using Metasploit for the first time, I have a detailed video explaining what Metasploit is and its basic usage. You can find the link to that video in the description below, and I'll also pop it up on the screen right now. It's a great starting point if you're new to this powerful tool. Alright, let's dive into the installation process of Metasploit in Ubuntu. We'll go through this step by step, and I'll explain each part in detail so you can follow along easily, even if you're new to Linux or cybersecurity tools. First things first, let's open a terminal. You can do this by pressing Ctrl+Alt+T. Or by searching for terminal in your applications menu. Once you have your terminal open, we need to update our system. This is crucial because it ensures our system knows about the latest versions of all packages, including Metasploit. Let's paste this command into our terminal. Alright, now that our system is up to date, we need to install some dependencies before we can install Metasploit. Dependencies are other software packages that Metasploit needs to function correctly. Let's paste this command. These packages and dependencies are crucial for installing Metasploit on Ubuntu, as they provide the necessary tools and libraries for compiling and running Metasploit's various components, especially those related to database integration, network functionality, and Ruby-based operations. Now that we have all the necessary dependencies, let's download the Metasploit installer. We'll use a command that downloads a script directly from the Metasploit GitHub repository. Here's the command. Let's paste it. This script is designed to make the installation process as smooth as possible. It's regularly updated by the Metasploit team to ensure it works with the latest versions of Ubuntu and other Linux distributions. Now that we've downloaded the installer script, we need to make it executable. In Linux, files aren't automatically given permission to run as programs for security reasons. We need to explicitly mark our installer as an executable file. We do this with the following command. Now we're now ready to run the installer. Here's the command. While we're waiting, let me explain a bit about what's happening behind the scenes. The installer is not only downloading Metasploit but also setting up a PostgreSQL database for it to use, configuring your system's environment to work with Metasploit, and ensuring all the Ruby gems that Metasploit needs are installed and up to date. This command starts the Metasploit console, which is the main interface you'll use to interact with Metasploit. The first time you run this, it might take a moment as Metasploit sets up its database. When Metasploit launches, you'll see a stylized M logo and some information about the version you're running. You're now ready to start using Metasploit. And there you have it. You've successfully installed Metasploit on your Ubuntu system. Remember, Metasploit is a powerful tool used by both security professionals and malicious hackers. Always use it responsibly and ethically, and make sure you have permission before testing any systems you don't own. In future videos, we'll dive deeper into how to use Metasploit for various cybersecurity tasks. Thank you for watching this video on the installation of Metasploit in Ubuntu. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends who are interested in cybersecurity. Let me know in the comments below what other tools or topics you'd like me to cover. Are you interested in learning about other penetration testing tools? Or maybe you want to see how to use specific Metasploit modules? Your feedback helps me create content that's most useful to you. Don't forget to subscribe to TechSky for more tutorials and tech tips. Until next time, happy hacking, and remember to always hack ethically and responsibly.